Greetings, I am Herbert Erpaderp, and last weekend I visited the Queensland Model Hobbies Expo, which took place in Redbank, just outside of Brisbane, Queensland, Australia. I have been to this yearly event before. It was pretty good the first time I went, but I have to say it's gotten better since then. I don't much care for the competitive aspect of it, but I do love seeing the amazing work on display, and there is a good amount of stuff for sale as well. Boxes upon boxes of stuff from, I believe, mostly local stores. I was really tempted to buy this Energia and Baran. It was a bit outside of my budget though. Oh well, let's look at the models. I'm pretty sure that's what everybody is here for, though you should expect some intermittent waffling. These figures were really quite convincing. If it wasn't for the background, you could be forgiven for thinking some of these were real actual people. Maybe they are real people. Perhaps these modelers have a debigulator. There's even some naked ladies. Demonetization ahoy! I think planes are the most represented topic at this show. That's not a complaint. Planes can be pretty darn interesting. And there were a whole lot of really nicely done aircraft. And a nice wide variety. Airliners, fighters, jets, piston-engined aircraft, biplanes, all sorts. Tanks were also quite well represented. None of that is really surprising though. I would imagine tanks and planes to be the two most popular type of model. That said, they're obviously not the only kind of model, and there are a lot of other very interesting things here. If you've been around my channel or streams, you might know that I rather enjoy Centurions. And this diorama is amazing. It's inspired me a lot with my own Centurion build. Like the spotlight being stowed. I didn't know that was a thing, but now I'm considering it. And look at that puddle on the ground. This is just awesome. Also, look at this Mad Max truck. brilliant. Cars are also a pretty popular topic for models, not surprising considering the area. But something caught my eye. Look at this giant robo shooty man. How cool is this? I think he's just about to blast that bridge out from underneath the bicycle man. Of course, there was at least some model trains, and I really liked the weathering on this one. Also, I like the pink boxcar. If you didn't already realise, model trains are awesome. I've no idea what this gigantic rocket is from, but I really like it. It's super interesting and very well done. A mirror for a base is a really good idea. Great for seeing the underside detail of things like planes. Whoever thought of this is very clever. You might assume that all of these models are made by adults, but that's not true. Some of the models here are made by quite young people. They look great, and I'm really pleased to see young people getting involved in the hobby. I was really impressed by this burnt out truck. We do see a lot of models where the subject is brand new or at least intact, but destroyed, not so much. It might be a little bit morbid or something, but I think it's quite interesting. I have to say, this good doggo was the most convincing model at the entire show. Very realistic. It even moves. Awesome work. I really wanted to pat the dog. This boat really impressed me. Not only is it very well done, as you can see, but it's also a very interesting subject, which I suppose you can also see. I could believe this boat is in the middle of sailing along somewhere and the people have just disappeared, leaving the tools and cup right there on that box. It looks lived in and used. This Romulan bird of prey is another great example of using a mirror as a display base. It makes it very easy to see that bird on the underside. A KV2. Everybody likes a good strong derp tank. I didn't really see a whole lot of KV2s. In fact, I think this might be the only KV2 that I saw. But it is one of my favourite tanks, so I figured I should point it out and say how awesome I think it looks. Because it does look awesome. just look at these amazingly done pieces of armour. They're really inspiring. I know a lot of modellers when they see this sort of thing will say, well, I give up, or something similar, but I think that's the wrong way to look at it. Surely these awesome models should be an example to strive toward, rather than a discouragement. They really do look amazing, and I bet a lot of time has gone into them. More really convincing figures. I especially like this kid with his pet lizard, or I'm assuming it's a pet anyway. And if it is, I'm a little bit jealous. What I'm trying to say is I want a pet lizard. Another amazing Mad Max truck. This one is in a smaller scale, but it does include a full scene with other rad cars. This is so good. It's really made me want to do some more Mad Max inspired post-apocalyptic builds. Round and round we go. How do you like this for a piece of furniture? I would absolutely love to have this in my lounge room. What a great idea. Executed amazingly too. These are some awesome dioramas. They've all been done quite amazingly, really, but I rather like this flipped over APC. Apparently, this is based on a real incident involving a friend of the modeler. Not a pleasant situation for them to experience, of course, but the result is a fantastic model. Great Scott! I have to admit, I would really love to own this DeLorean, even though I don't really have anywhere that I could put it. I would find a place. This is a fantastic concept. I think this might be the most interesting way I've seen to display vehicles with detailed interiors. I really like it, and I'm tempted to try something like this myself in the future sometime. Cutaways are another good way to show the interior, like this King Tiger, which is the same kit as the previous one. Obviously, just displayed a bit differently. The builder of these wonderful ships told me that it took him quite a few months to build each of them. The decking alone looks simply amazing, and I was rather impressed. This jet with its bits exposed looks rather good. I really like seeing models that show off their interiors effectively like this. I kind of wonder if this is the way the kit is meant to be built, or if there's a bunch of kit bashing and scratch building involved. As you can see, there isn't really any information provided, but that's okay, it's still great to see. Gooch. I think I've found the perfect car for me. I think I'm sensing a theme here. Maybe they really like green. Okay, so that was my experience of the Queensland Model Hobbies Expo. I really enjoyed seeing all of the models, and I left feeling quite inspired. But not before I picked up a couple of kits. It is a small haul, to be fair, but I think these are going to be fun to build, and that's what matters. If you want more information about the expo, I'll put some links in the description. Sadly, if you wanted to go this year, you've missed it, but there's always next year. I hope you find all the models in this video inspiring. If you're new to the channel, check out some of my other videos, and if you feel like it, feel free to subscribe, follow, ring the bell, and all the other things you do on YouTube and social media. Links to all of the things, including my Patreon and Twitch channel, are in the description below. You can also find the YouTube join button down there somewhere too. As always, I shall return soon, so until then, be excellent to each other, and thanks for watching. Farewell.